spend some money or something. You know,
hey, Bruce. Yes. Who did you serve with?
How do you do?
Third Army, Third Light Light Courage.
Yes, sir.
Third Light Light Courage.
I'll say a few words.
In France, but I went over to many, in 1940 with West Nova Scotia Regiment.
West Nova Scotia.
Artillery, Army.
That's the third division, isn't it?
The first division.
Rather, first division.
I went overseas in May 1940.
May 1940.
At 18.
We always
needed the adventure.
I had a long time there. I had the whole trip.
So what was what theater did you serve in first?
Theater, I served in Battle of Britain. The Battle of Britain. And then the Battle of Germany, the Battle of France, the Battle of Holland, the Battle of Belgium, and the Battle of Germany.
What were you doing the war?
Battle of Britain, what's your particular
memory? Oh, my goodness gracious, is all the bombing that was taking place and all the fighting that was going on and everything else there, especially the Spitfires, who I think saved Britain's life at that time because they were
so... The Hurricanes and Spitfires.
Yeah, Hurricanes and Spitfires.
They really bore the brunt of it, right?
They were so good. They were so good that they saved Britain at that time. There's no doubt about it. No doubt.
And lucky the Germans, I've just got this on. Lucky the Germans didn't figure out the radar.
Exactly, you're right. They didn't. Yeah.
It was a little late when they a little late when they figured out what the heck it was doing.
Yeah.
You know. But your particular experience in Normandy.
Well, it's hard to explain that kind of experience because war is hell, especially when you're up against an enemy like that we had with their big guns that they had right on the coast and firing down on us and everything else as we were coming in. And we were artillery, so we had to get our trucks loaded onto special ramps being built for us and everything else so we could get out of the water and get in.
Right.
And bodies, of course, in the water and bodies all around us.
What beach did you come in on?
The Juno Beach, Cossette.
Cossette.
Bernières-sur-Mer.
Queenstown Rifles.
Queenstown Rifles came in there, too. Yeah, we are also... they nicknamed it Juno Beach.
What can you tell me about your memories of the Queen's Own Rifles coming in on Bernières-sur-Mer?
Not a hell of a lot because we're too busy. Our artillery, our gun is attached to the truck with a Bofors gun.
Bofors.
So we were able to fire.
Anti-aircraft, right.
Anti-aircraft. We were able to fire an anti-aircraft while we were coming in. Don't forget, we're still able to do that because we could do it right by having the man on the gun, by having the four guys on the gun.
Right.
Two people, one guy loading, one guy elevating, the other guy, what do you call it?
Swivel on the turret?
Yeah, right.
And then the other one firing.
And then the other one firing,
right.
See? So we were movable.
Did you experience, what's your experience of any Luftwaffe that may have been in the area?
Oh my goodness.
We
had four of them come down on us. Four.
Were these bombers or fighters?
No, these were fighters.
Okay.
And all of a sudden, in that particular incident that I'm talking about, or I'm explaining it, the Spitfires arrived somewhere. I don't know where they come from.
Like
but they
angels
were there.
Out of the sky, eh?
Yes, but like God sent them, you know?
Right.
And they blew three of them down right away. Right away. And they were turning on a dime, like, you know? They were so good, it's hard to explain it.
They had their experience in the Battle of Britain.
Oh, God, yes. Did they
that's where they got their experience.
That's where they got it.
Well, okay. Bruce, it was a pleasure meeting you.
God bless you.